Yes!
I can't hear you!
Yes!
Great! Then you're sure to love this. Never mind BO5 or L'Oreal Paris or any of those other hairsprays. We have the best hairspray. But of course, I'm not trying to be mean because we are the nicest kids in town.
Yeah.
or simply sit there looking mortified at this crazy duo, it's Chloe and Ina with Vaudeville!
Why do I even bother? wasting time.
Like this. Hiya! Is it 13 ones there?
Yes, 13.
So yeah, my turn. Scan it. Beep. Should be in the back of my list, yeah.
Love.
maybe just throw up a little. Never mind. Right, next up, we have an act that is sure to keep you on the edge of your seat. If you're trying to hide singing and dancing along, that is, get ready for a lip-syncing battle.
Ladies and gentlemen, you are part of the biggest battle in the world. Only the lip sync battle! Woo! In the red corner, we have the terrible but one and only Shaniqua!
All right, so Pink Just an empty, well, there's nothing there. what my mama said.
Your mama says nothing. We might as well go for one more try before Miss Piggy gets here.
Mr. Anderson, they have been expecting you.
Yes, tonight.
Of course it will end, but how it will end, I hear you ask? It is simple. Only the DJ at the back can end this right now, Mr. Anderson.
I will stop you.
Yeah. Me and my good old friend here, Chloe, are doing a raffle.
Yeah.
So if you wanna...
If you wanna win a teddy, a giraffe...
Woo!
You've got to guess his name,
so it can be like Shaniqua, Charlie, Tolofi, Edward, basically anything, so... And the cafe over there selling alcohol. You didn't get it from me.
So yeah, there's refreshments from the bar over there, and there's a raffle hosted by these two beautiful ladies. So enjoy the break. See you soon.
Let's see magic. raw. It might touch some people in different ways. But no, I need to tell you a story first. You remember the accident with the Chelsea fans and a black man in the metro and they kicked him out?
Yeah.
Well, do racist people go into pubs, order a pint, sip the white bit, and then throw the rest away? Well, the next thing you know, Chelsea fans are again in the tabloid. But this time, they have opened up a bakery called the Cake Shop. Got that out of the way. So now, can we bring on LeVar Burnett when he's singing his song with comedy?
I hope you enjoyed the show. Some people may not understand my jokes, they may not even like them. And that's the point of the show. I want you to just enjoy it, not clap in the awkward silence or cheer when there's nothing to cheer. I want you to exit this room afterwards and think, eh, it's alright. I think there's nothing more manly someone can do than take a shower with 500 men. I mean, it's true, very caveman-like, going through the mist. 500 people adventuring themselves. Very sapient like. No homo. And I like to tell you a story, because I like to mix up things. I had a bed this morning, and afterwards I felt like this. Because I couldn't control my stools. Thank you. And I'd like to tell you a poem of mine. It's from my new book. It won't be out now, but if anyone comes afterwards and asks, I'll gladly give you a copy. I've been working it since I was a little boy. It's the poem of a dog. And I'd like to give you an extract from it. Roses are grey, violets are a different shade of grey. Let's go chase cars. Thank you. Perform a song to you. It comes to me on night time and I think of what the audience would like. And it's called The World on Fire. It's about adventure, exploration, and determination. It goes like this.
Ah! Somebody help! Please! Ah! No!
Okay, the next song is a little bit longer than the last one. And it's called Sad. It's about all the sad things that happen in the world. I'm really, really sad.
Just imagine a depressed onion cutting itself. I met a homeless man named Rich. Isn't that terrible? I saw a fly, a four-lost dog, and the dog didn't have any legs. I saw a diabetic kid trick-or-treating. I saw an old man get hit by a train. He didn't see it in the pouring rain. He didn't hear me shout, look out for the train. So I didn't say anything. I just thought to myself, ooh, this is gonna be sad. It was. I saw a man who only had one eye. In a 3D movie, I saw a cat stuck in a tree, then the can jumped up and it hung itself. I saw a man at his funeral. And then a little boy who had red hair too. I went to the store looking for something to buy, but they only sold paintings of the same sad guy. No, wait! This store sells mirrors, you see what I did there? Let's rock! No. The world's so sad, though. Pain, genocide, war, sexism, racism. But you gotta remember, there's good things about it, too. Like the fact that all that's happened to me. Score! No, seriously, how'd you all do it? I've been telling you all sad, terrible things this entire time. You haven't been sad at all. You've been happy, no. You've been laughing. That's it. Laughing's the key to solve everything. I mean, not for the people that are actually sad, but people have got to fucking deal with them all the time. Being a comedian is about being a sensitive prick capsulizing the most animalistic impulse of the public. It's being a hero. thank you.
Thank you, LeVar. That was wonderful. How was your childhood and then where are your parents?
It was great.
Okay. Now, we should all smile a little bit after that act, you know? People smiling on TV, for example. Happy housewives. Their marriage has fallen apart, their kids hate them, but they're still scrubbing away. I don't want to know what cleaning products they are using. I want to know what medication they are on. All right. The next act taught me a lot of things, like, with the haircut that the lady has, I will look like a prostitute. Also, I do not look good dancing with a chair, and I'm not very flexible. So, get out Ali Rowland and all that jazz on stage!
Thank you.
She does that pretty well herself. So can she please come on stage?
Hello everybody. How you all doing?
Great.
Good, good. Can I just have some love for Vicky G? She is pretty awesome. Anyway, my name is Christine Gladys. Anyone trying to train yourselves?
Yes!
Could I get a woo? Woo! Are you that gullible for me? Okay, say bye. Bye. Come on! Anywho, so you probably want to know a bit about me. I'm from the US of A. I came over here on a private jet. Oh yeah. Anywho, I came here with a guy called Preacher Jack. Yeah. He's coming up pretty soon. A little word of warning. He is a preaching pervert. Honestly, he does not just use his hands for preaching or praying. On the way here, 16 hours straight, hands all over me. It was like I had a bloody rash. That is not ethical. That is not ethical. Anywho, thank you, I appreciate the laughs. So you probably want to know a bit about me, as I was just saying. Well, some people eventually, after I've done a gig, as you call it, we call it a stage performance, but you call it a gig. Okay. Basically, somebody came up to me and said, Christine, are you related to John Lennon? Can you imagine? Come on, you sung the song! So you know this one. Anywho, the next day I was in the studio, oh yeah, with Paul McCartney, of course, and I was telling him about it, and he said, at the end of the day, Christine, just let it be. That was yesterday. Love the Beatles. And I talked to Ringo about it as well, but he just said something about Eleanor Rigby and Yellow Submarine. Oh, and Thomas the Tank Engine. Okie dokie. But I'm not perfect. I'm not perfect. No. My first agent actually said to me, Christy, you have the ego the same size as Justin Bieber's. And I was like, what do you mean? Sorry! And he said, Christine, you'll never get to Carnegie Hall. Never say never. If you don't know what that was, it was a song. Okay. So, I'm going to be singing for you. Do you like songs? Yeah. Do you like singing?
Yeah!
Good, because I'm doing both of those, oh yeah. Okay, so I'm just going to shimmy over here.
Jimmy.
Adventure! Because I'm lazy, I don't like sit standing up.
So?
This song is called Rock Ferry. It's about heartbreak, trains, shadows, stars, and all that sloppy shit that you get.
So,
I would love it if the mic show hit the music. Recently,
my ex-boyfriend got back in touch. No, because I'm so successful. Anywho, he said, I love you, get back with me, please. So, I did what every girl would. And I sent him a video message. I took a little inspiration from my friend, LeVar Burnett. And this is how it goes. Roses are red, violets are blue. I've moved on now, so fuck you!
Are there any thespians, Shakespearean fans in here tonight? No, honestly, no. I will tell you why. Because these guys have turned Romeo and Juliet upside down and kicked it in the balls. So can I have Romeo and Juliet on stage? Woo!
I was there too.
We're gonna get married in town.
Sassy.
Close your eyes.
Oh, for God's sake, Rona.
This one, you actually love it.
Yeah,
go on.
What is that?
Look, it says Rupert, named after your daddy.
Rupert?
Oh, name my dad's called Bill.
Second of all, I don't need the name.
You're just not right now.
No, I'm really not.
Because you know what, Romeo? I don't love you. I don't want to marry you. Do you want to know why?
Because I'm lesbian.
What?
I'm lesbian.
So, you know what?
You can have your flowers. You can have your flowers, whatever it is.
It's a funky memory.
You're a lesbian, guess what?
Yeah, I'm a girl.
You're a girl.
Guess what my name is?
It's not Romeo, it is Romeana.
You're lying.
Let's run away now.
No,
I've got even better plans.
Let's go to the moon.
Well, that literally took a turn. Okay. I got one word. And one word only for you. Boom! Yes!
So hard to bear, you got a fever. When you kiss me, fever when you hold me tight. Fever in the morning, fever all through the night.
It's a cold and crazy world, it's raging outside. Me and all my girls are bringing on a fire. Show a little leg. Gotta shimmy your chest. It's a life that's a style. It's a me. It's burlesque.
Oh,
Thank God we don't have the same changing rooms. Jeez. Okay, guys. You know, after that, I think I should teach you a little chat line. You know, you're in a club and you're like, yeah. And you're like, wow. So go up to that person, take them to the bar, grab an ice cube and smash it. And then you say, now that I've broke the ice, will you sleep with me? Okay. Yeah. So I think we all need to be baptized now. And again, before we'll spend the budget. So we've got in a guy from the USA. There's an American guy here somewhere. There is one, I know. Put your hand up. No? Never mind. USA is great. But this guy preach a church!
My brothers and sisters, my name's Reverend Jack. You can tell from my accent that I'm not from around here. I've come all the way from South America to be with y'all tonight. Because our other girl sing that rock fairy song. I don't know, I've heard what she's been saying, and I don't tell you now, I've heard, they ain't true. I swear to God, they ain't true. I don't know what she's on with the Lord's Prayer. Now, I may miss my home, I'm a wife. Wait, that don't sound right. Now, I may miss my home, but I can tell I just spent a few days in hope that I needed here. I see many sinners in your town, but they do not listen to me. Never I try to explain to them why they're sinners, but they just chase me away with knives. It's like, that's not a good sign, oh no. So I decided to come to y'all. Not so royal variety, because there are always sinners among college students. You are all in dire need of my help, and I will not leave until I cleanse every last sinner here. Maybe a song will help you see the light. Let us sing so that the good Lord may hear us.
I will follow. Sunshine team's here and you can take a break. I'm a hot and alone like a girl's space. Yeah, I gotta care if everybody's ready. Level all the day you feel like you're without me. I'm all the way to you.
to be, but who knows? But I'm not going to let you people down, and I'm still going to do Uptown Funk.
Goodbye.
chairs and they'll come in. Okay.